sales from every per month on all insured and all self-insured. That 525 declines over 3 years, and it's the actual amount for the federal reinsurance program is fixed at, I think it's $10 billion in the first year. I mean, it's fixed at with a national number. The Wakely report originally indicated, if we go back to the slide, that the impact of the federal reinsurance program in the first year is it would reduce premiums in the individual market by 8%. At the time that report was written, the actual outline of how the federal program would operate was not known. And now we have better information that the federal program will have in the first year, if you think of that, just average 38, which was had a minus 8 in it, that minus 8 now is a minus 11. So it will tend to lower the premium impact because this program will help pick up the higher cost claims as people either are moving out of OMIP, in our case, or moving into an insured non-medically underwritten market. So it's to help buffer, if you will, the change that's going on.
That's done to 35.
Let's say again?
It's done to 35. The Wakely estimate, you know, goes from 38 to 35.
Well, that's good. Let me go back. Here's
because it's minus 8, this is minus 11.
Yeah, right here, this is minus 9, minus 8, minus 7. I think that minus 8, I would say, is now minus 11, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, which is the bottom.
Yeah, right, okay. Now, the risk corridor, the risk corridor is used to mitigate, this is to help a lot of these programs.